Some 5,000 years ago, when the Dwapar Yuga was coming to an end and Kali Yuga was yet to commence, that time was a very difficult phase for the Earth. Evil forces were determined to disrupt the epitomes of faith and rituals from the Earth. It was then that Lord Vishnu decided to re-establish faith and take birth in the human form on Earth. This remarkable incarnation of Vishnu was known as Param Yogi Krishna and also known as Leeladhar. Along with Sri Krishna, his brother Balram too defeated a lot of demons with his sheer strength. Now, whether you call him Kanha or naughty Krishna, the whole of Vrindavan was smitten by him.
Aha! What a wonderful day! The cool breeze blowing. And the lovely fragrance of the flowers. All of this is so mesmerizing.
What is it, Krishna? You seem to be in a poetic mood today.
Radha, this picturesque view of the Yamuna is so beautiful that it inspires one to write poetry. Don't you think?
Really?
Hey, listen! Which world are the two of you lost in?
Huh?
Don't tell me that we are going to indulge in poetry all day.
Oh no, Udho. We are going to play on the soft mud alongside the banks of the river Yamuna with this ball I have.
The whole of mankind is embroiled in chaos because of the wicked activities of demons on Earth. The entire planet is in grave crisis. If this destruction continues unabated, then humans shall no longer continue to have faith in God.
Narayan, Narayan.
Munivar, can you hear this remarkable voice? Who can it be on Earth whose melodious voice can reach all the way to Brahmalok?
Hey, it's my turn. Give the ball to me.
What are you doing?
Hey. Oh, my turn.
So there you have it. Madhav, I don't think it would be possible to defeat Krishna as long as he has Radha on his side.
Yes, you are right in your observation there.
Before you can think of defeating Krishna, you shall have to face me, Udho.
Really? So much for being Krishna's protector. Take this. Looks like we'll have to defeat Radha before we can get to Krishna. And in order to defeat Radha, we'll have to take care of Krishna first.
Yes, this is turning out to be some puzzle,
which I believe is impossible for either of you to solve.
Kanha, will you keep protecting me from difficulties like these always?
What makes you think that you'll ever have to face any sort of trouble as long as I'm around?
Udho, to defeat Kanha, we shall have to ask Baldao to throw the ball at him.
Yes, I think you have a plan there. Baldao? Baldao? Listen!
These two boys are absolute fools.
That they obviously are. Baldao will never do anything against Kanhaiya.
No, this won't be possible.
Why don't you hit Krishna with the ball yourself?
How do we do it?
It is so difficult to catch him in the first place.
Think of a plan and then hit him with the ball.
Plan?
Why not?
Hey, Kamla, Mania, Amla, listen. Come over here now. Come here, listen.
Kanha, I'm sure these guys are plotting something.
Don't worry about it, Radha.
Kanha? Kanha? We were thinking why don't we make two separate groups?
Sure. Why not? Tell me, who would like to be a part of my team?
Krishna, why are you troubling the children like this?
Baldav, who told you I'm up to something? I'm just playing a game.
Yes. You think I'm not aware of the game you're playing?
Muni Shresht, who is this child? He is quite charming and very naughty as well.
Don't be fooled, Brahmadev. Though he may appear to be a mere child, but he is none other than the incarnation of our Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu has taken incarnation in the human form on the planet Earth to rid it of all the demons. And now, this charming and naughty child has become the nemesis of all demons and evil forces on Earth. Narayan, Narayan.
But Munivar, as you just pointed out, he has taken birth in the human form. I'm extremely curious to know, how would Lord Vishnu, with the limited strength of a human being, defeat any demon?
Come, let's all bathe in the river.
If our mother saw us in this state, she'd be very angry with us. In fact, she wouldn't even let us enter the house. Let's hurry.
Yes, let's go.
Let's jump into the river.
All right, Kana, tell us, for how long can you hold your breath and stay underwater?
Forget Kana. Speak for yourself.
Inside the water? Forget that. He's scared of swimming on the surface itself. Can't you see the effort he's making to stay afloat even in the shallow? Hey! Hey, where did our Kanha disappear?
You remember Madhu asking him, how long could he stay underwater? Well, he must have gone under to show you just that.
Narayan, Narayan. Lord, please do tell me, what is it that you are looking for specifically that would reaffirm your belief that Krishna is truly the one with superhuman powers?
You shall get to know in a short while.
Instruct us, Brahmadev.
Do you see all those children playing on the banks of the river Yamuna?
Look, Radha, look. What a beautiful fish.
Wow, beautiful. This fish is really very pretty. Look at its golden colored scales.
Yes, we can see them.
I want you to take all those children prisoner and bring them here to me in Brahmalok.
As you command.
Narayan, Narayan, what is this that you're doing?
Keep watching, Devarshi.
Narayan, Narayan.
Come, let's fill up the water quickly. Come, let's hurry.
Yes, or Kana will be here and he will break our pots.
No, Kana never breaks any...
Let it be, Radha. We all know Kana very well.
Where did they all disappear? Oh, it seems they all went underwater ahead of me. Fine then. Must have caught Baldao and the rest.
Kana, what do we do now? How do we find all of them? I'm really scared now.
Don't be scared, Radha. Whatever happens, we shall find them. Come.
Let's go.
Krishna!
Huh?
Krishna!
Oh, Krishna, just a little while back, I heard some of Radha's friends screaming and shouting helplessly. Someone was taking them forcefully via the route in the sky.
That thing did not seem like a demon, but it did not seem like a creature from this planet either.
If you wish, Krishna, I can help you find your friends that this creature has taken away.
This cannot be the work of some demon or human, but this has to be that of a divine power. We definitely have to find out which divine creature it is now.
Come on. Come with me.
Yes, let's go now.
Let's go.
Goodness, that's a huge demon, Kana.
Kana, the terrifying demon is heading directly towards us. Save yourself, Krishna.
Garudji, don't you worry at all.
Krishna, it won't be that easy to get past me and reach Brahmalok.
Narayan, Narayan. Lord, you must be convinced beyond doubt now that Krishna is the incarnation of Lord Vishnu and not an ordinary being. Narayan, Narayan. What is the implication behind that laughter of yours, Brahmadev? Are you going to put Sri Krishna through yet another test?
Right now, we are in Brahmalok, Radha.
What? We are in Brahmalok? But why are we here?
This only Brahmadev can tell us. Brahmadev, pranam. Pranam, Munivar.
I beg your forgiveness, Yashoda Nandan, for putting you through this test of mine. I was just testing your incarnation in the human form.
Brahmadev, it doesn't matter. Whenever there's a doubt in one's mind, then it's best that one seeks a resolution and be satisfied.
Narayan, Narayan. What you said is absolutely correct, Yashoda Nandan.
But Devarshi, it is also inappropriate to suspect someone without any reason whatsoever.
Narayan, Narayan, this too is very true, my lord.
Brahmadev, this test of yours has caused a problem of sorts for all of us.
What sort of problem, Yashoda Nandan?
The time you took to put me through this test took only a few moments of your time. But in this duration, an entire year has passed by on Earth. Everyone shall now be concerned about us down there. What shall I tell them when I return to Earth?
Why don't you only tell me the solution to this problem as well?
There's only one solution. You turn the wheel of time in the opposite direction and place Earth exactly a year back in time, from where we came.
Narayan, Narayan.
Sure. It shall be done. Thus ended another conquest in the story of Krishna and Balram.